we are continuing to look at the strategic aspect, how to convert an advantage into a win. And this week we are looking at positions involving a remote passed pawn. Already we have seen, I think right from level 2, we have been hearing and learning about the remote passed pawn. Nandan is joining, good. Remote passed pawn and how it helps. So, but the concept remains same, but there are more and more advanced examples as we will see. Some will start from simple, but then there are some slightly complicated examples, but still finally the win is based on the remote passed pawn, but the advantage may not be as obvious or as simple to convert. Okay, so still it is important to see various examples and then see how it is taken forward. First thing to understand is that remote passed pawn is materially big advantage only when only the kings are left. If, for example, if the kings are there and one rook is there, then while that is still an advantage, but it doesn't seem to be as big an advantage as it is when there are no rooks, for example, right? So it is like that. And if there are no rooks, only bishops are there, for example, then also it is difficult for you to advance the remote pawn because your bishop will be only of one color, right? And in the end game, and if the it is difficult to advance in such a case if thing is there. So remember, the outside passed pawn is an advantage when especially in a king and pawn endgame, right? That is where it is advantageous. Okay, so look at this position. Okay, I think it will be very clear to obvious to everyone who has the advantage and who should be winning this. But what should be the first move?
B3.
Somebody is saying B3.
B3, A3, B4.
Okay. Anyone else?
So first A3 and then B4.
A3, then A4.
Yeah, very, very, very correct. Okay. So this is a fundamental principle in the pawns, again, that you have to realize. See, black on the queen side, black has got a pawn on A5. White has got two pawns. Now you want to convert it into a one passed pawn, right? You will exchange one of the pawns and then the other pawn will become a passed pawn, right? Now you have to see which one will you advance. And
B3
then A3 is correct, because what happens is you have to think otherwise. So Pranav, so if you first play A3, black will play A4. And now your B pawn can also not advance. Because if it advances, then it will take A pasa. And then black pawn is much faster to the queening square than the white pawn. Right? So that is the reason why. And this rule was given by Mimzovich. Okay? And it is a correct rule that whenever you are trying to create a pass pawn like this, first you advance the pawn which is not having another opponent pawn in front of you. In this case, B pawn is the one that you should advance first. Okay, B3.
I think I've forgotten that we have chess class right now.
Oh, okay. Fine, no problem. So B3 is what you should play first. Hello? So that even if black plays A4, black will not play A4 anymore, right? Because he will get killed. And then you play B3, then A3, then B4. I think someone is creating a noise. I think you can go on mute, whoever thing. So there is some background noise was coming. So, okay, good. Fine. However, that does not mean, in this position, okay, B3 is correct. A3 will lead to actually black will win, okay, if you play A3. So, sometimes it can become that devastating. So, let me pin my video and it is there. Let me go to this mode, single video mode, okay. Fine. So B3 first, and then black plays King D5. Then you play A3. Black king is basically now will be forced to divert away, right? This is still very important. Again, if you play A4, again, it is, remember, this is also wrong because This will mean that you cannot advance the B pawn, and then black actually might win. In fact, here the black will probably win. Yeah, now if you do this, then this is actually going to, black is going to win it, because black king is much better placed now with respect to all these pawns and this one, right? So remember, that's why here after king e5, you have to play b4 and then create this passed pawn, okay? And now you know the technique. Now what will happen is you will push the pawn, let the black king divert, then you take this pawn, black king will take it, you come here. This is now, after this it is very simple, right? This is all simple, okay? Fine. So we will go to, now actually we'll go to some examples where it becomes more complicated, and that's why I think we'll start with a basic example. So, but still we learned that important point of which pawn should move first. Now let us go to the next one. Let's go to the next example. Yeah, here it is black to play. Black to play, think about it. And
Queen e3 check.
Yes, yes. Queen e3 check, because you force the exchange of the queens, and now you have to assess it, what will happen after. I mean, you have to just assess the move, about three moves after this, what will happen. So black will take the h pawn, will take g, sorry, a b here it is. Yeah, white will take the a will take the b pawn, black will take it. But now if you see, black has got an extra pawn and it is a remote passed pawn. So now you will be able to divert. So black king will approach the white pawns. Yeah, first of all, white king will be, you can't save that pawn. So white king will take it. But black king is now reaching. See, for all these calculations, you have to see how much time it will take for which king to reach where, etc. It is not so obvious. Here, I mean, we went by the general principles, but actually you have to calculate all of this. So now white king goes to d2 and creates the opposition, right? He creates the opposition. So now black simply plays g5. And now, you know, I mean, white king will be diverted to the black pawn, g pawn, and then black will go pick up the d3 pawn, and after that both the e4 and the c4 pawns, and then he will be able to convert, right? So while this again looks very, very simple, but before you decide to exchange the queens, you have to calculate all the way up to, see, we are in first move here, we have to calculate up to this up to here you have to calculate. So seven moves, sometimes it is seven moves ahead, five, six moves ahead, you have to calculate, and you have to assess what will be this position and is this winning for you. But if this is not winning, and sometimes, I mean, it may look, there are so many positions which with a small mistake or a small loss of tempo, the win will shift from white to black, right? Or black to white. So it can happen like that. So you have to be careful. Now we will see the third example, will actually show you how this one it can get, okay? So this is a quite, okay, now you just look at this position and we will try and play this position on board, okay? We will try to put it on the Lichess board and we'll see. But what does it look like? Actually, it is not that white does not have a clear cut advantage as such, because white has got a remote pass pawn. Yes, that is an advantage. But on the king side, white has got two pawns versus black's three pawns. So it is not so clear. So let me put it. White's pawn is on g3 and h4. Black's is on f5, g6, h6. King is on c5. King is on d3 and pawn is on a2. Okay. So let's put this on the board. it is white to play. Okay, it is white to play.
Sir, how about
yes,
h5 and then king e3.
No, h5 and king e3. If you play h5, then black will simply play. What, you are offering the pawn and checking?
No, you can just play g5, right? And then
no. Black. But have you calculated this?
e4.
Huh?
e4.
Have you calculated this?
No.
Now if you play a4,
king b4, yeah,
now the black king goes towards the a,
king d4, yeah. Takes e5, king e5, sorry,
king where,
king d4,
king, yeah.
Black king takes.
No, not so fast.
Oh yeah, g5.
Then play g5.
So now h5?
No, king e5.
h5 then.
Now white can take. Because after the exchange, and the white king is closer to the black pawn.
Okay, so here maybe I will take this, no?
King e5.
That is why actually I did not want to, because then that pawn is falling there. So that is why I wanted to play this first.
Okay, now g takes.
G takes,
and
then you can go play g4.
And then play g4. But king will die.
King.
And you will still take it.
And then f5.
And then, yeah. Not f, then?
f5, yeah.
Then
yeah.
F5. Yeah. So this is going to
be, right?
Because you can still catch up, right? So let's go back. But there is a thing. So this is a plausible thing, okay? So let us look at a4. If you play a4, and that is why...
Instead of king b4, couldn't they just take g5?
g5 first. So you take
king e3.
King e3. King e3, then I think white will play. Black should play what? Black cannot push the pawn right now, right? Black cannot push the pawn right now. So let me promote this position. Okay. So a4, let's go back. I think what is we are saying? a4, and then what should white do? How much time does black have before this one? So let us play g5. How much time does black have before? King b4 doesn't look right. King b4.
He doesn't need to play king b4. He can wait until pawn goes to at least pieces. Yeah.
Before king e3 is a good move. Okay, king e3 is a good move. What if black king simply plays this? Then you will push
a5. This.
We'll play push pawn and. I will, it is. Yep. So why don't we, let us see a4, what is the best chance? Let us just look at the engine. Engine is also saying g5.
Yeah, it's still winning. Yeah. It's
still winning, right? g5, right? Yeah. g5 is the right, what we thought. Same thing.
So after g5, what does the engine say?
g5, not g, sorry, not this one. We are saying after this, play g5.
And then h5.
It is saying play h5. What if king e3?
What if
king e3?
Yeah, could you?
Oh, king e3 is saying now it is this one. Now it is saying it's a draw. After now you're saying king before. Because why? Because if you approach like this, what we thought is that
you lose a temp.
But he will simply take it, and if you play if you play, yeah, this is it, f4. This we missed. We thought that white will take it, black will take it, and again white will take it. No, it is not like that. If white takes it,
it takes the other g4, yeah.
Then you play h4. Now the white king will be finding it very difficult to catch up, or it will be a draw state. Right.
So it's h5, a4 and h5.
Yeah. So this is the thing. This is the, I think this we missed this. This tactic slightly we missed it. We saw up to here, but then we did not see, I mean, this part, I think this f4 idea, we saw f4, but we did not realize what should black options has. This is a very good option for black. Now, white king will have to go around to reach the right. White king will come here. Yeah. It is still a draw after this, right? Yeah. Because if black goes to attack this pawn, sorry, white goes to attack this pawn, then black will attack this pawn, and it's a draw anyway. So this is a beautiful, yeah. So these are the kinds of things that we have to, I mean, these are the intricacies in the pawn end games, right? What breakthrough will happen? So this is the reason why actually a4 is not considered the right move. What is considered the right move is a3 actually, because it's all about now what will play, because you are forcing black to come here.
How is that forced?
Okay, what will you do? Let us see. Let us play. We'll not
g5, same thing.
Okay, you play g5, then white will play h5. White has to play h5. Because white,
yeah, no, it's the same thing, but then how exactly is this correct?
No, it is not.
I mean, a4 is just as correct as a3 is, right?
No. So it is all about opposition and whose turn it is and what is the thing, right? So now let us see, because it will be apparent now.
Sir, f4 by black.
Where? Now or previous?
Now.
No, what? Now it is Black's turn.
Yeah, white will. Black will play f4.
Black, how can black play f4?
F4.
You are saying f4.
Yeah.
Then this takes.
Then. Then white will take it. Then it is very easy. Then it is very easy for white. Or not so easy also. It is not so easy. What if you take it, then it is very easy for one. You black should not take
g4.
It. Yeah, black.
It is even it. if you push, you just king e.
No, it is not so easy. So. Just see this. Let us just see this. Now what will this one do? White will
king two. No, king e3.
Yeah, king
e3.
E3 or e4?
E3.
Okay. Does it make a difference?
If it is king e3, then
this is still losing, right?
It's still winning for white. Yeah, exactly. Black's king cannot handle both.
Yeah, black's king cannot handle both. Yeah. So let us see. We played. So we played h5, then you played f4, and then white took it, huh?
Yeah, so f4 isn't, I mean,
so in this position, even if white played a4, It wouldn't have made a difference, right?
Yeah, how, yeah, exactly. How would A4 have made any difference compared to
E4? Which position? Now you're saying in the first position or this one?
Yeah, because this variation would be continued even after A4.
No, you are saying that first move white should play A4 and then also?
Yeah, I mean
A4 and A3 both are winning.
No. A4, yeah. We saw the problem, right? A4 may, now what? Black plays what? Black plays, not B4, black plays G5. Right.
The same idea continues, right?
No, yeah, and now you play h5 instead of king e3, you play h5 and swing.
No, there is a difference. There is a difference. Yeah, see previous thing and this one. So now what will you play here?
H5.
You will play h5. Okay. You will play h5. Now black.
For example, f4.
No. Wait. Now black need not play f4 now. Okay, black need not play. King can come to b4.
King d4.
Now king takes a4.
Now
king e5.
Now what will be?
And then takes.
Not takes.
But then king to e4.
King to e4.
King
to b4.
F5.
King.
Then king to f4.
Yeah.
King to?
King c4.
After knight
king c5, king f4.
Wait. First is?
Then king to f3.
King to?
No, that loses.
No, that
because
loses. So you have to play king to, king to c5.
Yeah, take the pawn.
Now, king takes.
Now.
And then f4, king.
No, yeah, but no, then right way in the opposition, no?
King f4, king f4.
King f4.
King f4, and then black plays.
King e5. Yeah, then king to e5. So right at the opposition, no? So it will win.
Yeah, then f6.
F6?
Yeah, f6. And then the black king is cornered.
And then king f5.
King f5.
King g6. And then f5 h5 to winning.
King to e6. Before, instead of... Yeah, now.
E6.
No, shouldn't... Yeah, then... pawn to f7. No, that won't work. Then king to f5. No. Can you go back?
Black has the position, right?
Wait, sir, but then the engine still thinks white is winning after a4, right?
No, I mean a4, but there was... Yeah, a4, it is still this one. We'll see. But see, I mean...
Wait, can you go... No, can you go forward?
Not here. King has to go to c5 only. You take it. King goes to d6. Then?
Now king
f4.
King f4. King e7.
King e5.
King e5. King f7.
F6.
F6. King f8.
No, then king to... King f4.
F5.
F5.
King
F4. F5,
King
F7.
No, King
F4. King? F4. King. Oh.
You want to triangulate?
Okay, right.
You want to triangulate? Huh? You want to triangulate?
No, but then black triangulates too, exactly.
Yeah.
Now, how about King to E4? Sir, you said opposition can be gained even if there is... There's three square.
Yeah, but then what's the point of opposition?
The triangulation, if the other side can also, then you can't make progress. Right?
So what will black play now?
King f8.
Okay.
As long as black has control of the f7 square, white can't get to g6.
Right. How about
king d5?
King d5.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
King f7.
Then king e5.
Then getting into a loop.
Same thing, right? King e5, king f8.
Okay. Yeah, it doesn't make any difference.
So can you go back a lot? Like.
So that is the reason. So that is the reason actually that if a4 is a premature move. Let us see what does the, okay, but the engine thinks it is still winning. And
wait. So go to king d4.
A4, king b4 is wrong. G5 is correct.
But h5.
Engine, let us put what the engine thinks. Okay, let us put what is the engine thinking. Then we play h5, which is correct. Okay. Then black say okay. The engine then we said. Yeah, it is saying it is still winning. Why it is saying, what is the miss that we missed? King b4, then king d4, king takes a4, king e5, f4, right?
Yeah, then g takes
f4, and then g4. This is, it says it is still winning this. Huh? We found somewhere. Okay.
Yeah. Sir, where can you see that white is winning?
At the top, it is showing, right?
57. That white bar.
At the top bar on the right side, it is showing plus 57.5.
Yeah. So, can you play a black?
Ah, see. Okay. Here, what it is saying is, at this point of time, what was our this one? If we play f5, then it is a loss. Not loss, it's a draw. See, we were over thing here. I think what it is saying is that you should hold the opposite, should let the this king, this one, but then black will play g3, correct? And your king will have to go back, and black king will approach, and then your king will come here, and king will come to b4. Now, if you take it, white king, black king will play d5. Why not d? Why not e4? Because after
g4.
After king g4, now you are losing that plot entirely. So
yeah.
that is why king d5, and then
it's not infinity.
Here is the thing. So it is saying king f3. Yeah.
So how? I mean, king e6 and then
king.
E6, why does it have to go back?
King e6 is black is giving too much way immediately, so black does not want to give that. So black playing.
And now f5. F5 now.
G3.
No sir, pawn to f5. What would happen?
Pawn to f5. When? Now.
Now, yeah.
Now pawn to f5, then you simply play this is draw.
Then yeah, king to g4. No.
Draw.
Wait, sir, could you check table base instead of stockfish?
Yeah, then king to.
Oh, it is saying it is no, not king f6. It is saying king to d6. It is saying. Huh?
Okay, this engine. Wait, sir, could you click that book icon?
Yeah, we will just
like go a few moves.
But we'll go back earlier. a few this one, I think.
Yeah, and then
how many tables? Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think table base is there for 7 thing also, right?
Yeah, so if table base thinks it's a winning endgame, then probably.
Okay, now it is too much. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, I think. Okay, this I think we should look up. This is a 7-member table, right?
Yeah, it's winning.
King e5 it is saying is winning. And everything else is drawn.
Ah, okay.
And g4 is losing. Okay, g4 obviously nobody will play. But if you play king e5, then again, what is it saying? Losing or everything is a losing. Including, it is saying g4 also is, why it is saying pawn move? G4 obviously will lose. F4 is, g crosses f4 is winning, it is saying. G crosses f4, capture. And after g crosses f4, g4 is also losing. G crosses f4 is also losing. everything is losing it. Yeah, actually, it can get very complicated. We have to see this. Okay, we have to see this. You have to revise your things. There is an instructive way to win with A3, but A4 also apparently the same way with slightly different thing comes into picture. Because here, what we see, ultimately this G4 is the move, and then it becomes very complicated, but looks like it is a table-based win. Right? So here now, King E3 and King D4 are winning. So King E3 is also winning, it is. Okay, King E3, then Black, I think what we would think is that Black should play to C5, right? Or C4, C4 or C5. And then King F2, it is saying. See, here it is saying King F2 is the way to win. Oh God, it is complicated. King G3. Yeah, I mean, what do we do? I think it is.
Sir,
no, it will win. It will win, but it is not so easy. Okay.
So there is only one correct move for every position.
Yeah. No, there are sometimes now there are many, but many times it is only one. Especially at the beginning.
Initially
there was only one. Yeah. Here King to E5 was the only thing. Here. Right? King to E5. And then depending on what Black plays. Okay, DTZ. DTZ, I know. What is the DTZ? The distance to?
It's the 50 move rule, right?
Yeah. No, there is a, in endgame table pages, there is something. One is a distance to mate. Okay, finish or mate, they call it. DTM, I think. And DTZ is where you go to a simpler position, which is very easily won. So, what is the distance to that? So, yeah, here they are saying that DTZ everywhere.
I searched it up and it's depth to zeroing move.
Yeah, depth to zeroing. That's what depth to zeroing is, like going to a simpler one end game kind of thing.
Right? Oh, okay.
So that is what it is. Either the depth to checkmate or a depth to mate or depth to simpler thing. So here the best chance for obviously if Black King plays something like King A3, King B3, King B4, all those things are useless, because you know that Black is simply going to take this and take this and take this. So there is no point. Either you have to play, there is no point in playing G4 also, because you are going to play King takes F4. So only real possibility for Black is not G4, sorry, not this, but to play F4. And now there is only one winning move for White, which is obviously G takes F4. That is obvious. And now, for Black, G takes F4 is clearly losing. So only move worth thing is G4. And now, White has got two moves which are okay. So, but naturally, just looking at it, we will think that King to E4 is the correct move. And now again, for G3 is a pawn move. But we will, maybe we will play G3 and then King to F3, right? And then we will play G2, King takes G2. And now, DTM means depth to checkmate, okay? That is 33. And DTZ is one. So they are saying that all this, I think any of the king moves, it is finding that, because it is already there in the table base. Okay, it is there in the table base. So just by looking, I think this is the opposition. So let me take this. King will, where will you play the king? F3, right here? Or king to b4 was better here. King to b4 was better. And king to f3.
Yeah, now white reaches the key squares.
White has reached the key square here, so we have gone wrong here. But the moment white reaches key square, it is very, very easy to win, right? It is actually white has. So this here. This is completely lost. This is completely lost. Okay, we are. Let us join back. Let us join back and let us continue this one. But we will look at some more. But I think we got a very good idea of the depth of the pawn endings. Let us join back and continue. Okay, I will end it right now, and I will start.